हेलो स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स, टिल नाउ आई टॉट यू दैट लेंचो वॉज वेरी सैड बिकॉज ऑफ डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ हिज क्रॉप्स, सो ही कुड नॉट स्लीप दैट नाइट. थ्रू आउट द नाइट ही केप्ट ऑन थिंकिंग व्हाट टू डू. देन ही थॉट ऑफ गॉड एंड ही वॉज श्योर दैट गॉड विल हेल्प हिम. दैट नाइट ही डिसाइडेड दैट ही विल राइट अ लेटर टू गॉड. So next morning, next Sunday, the following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. So next morning, early in the morning, he began to write a letter to God, and he decided that he himself would carry the letter to the town. He did not want to take any risk so that the letter may miss. So he decided that he will write a letter to God. Thereafter he will post it. Next, God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes because the hail storm. So he wrote in letter that, you can say, he requested God, please help me God, if you will not help me, my whole family will go hungry throughout the year. And he demanded 100 pesos to sow his field again until the next crops come to survive. So he needed 100 pesos to sow his field and to survive for that year. He wrote to God, he wrote everything in the letter. When he demanded 100 pesos, he told his whole story in the letter, that hailstorms destroyed his crops, that's why he needed 100 pesos and only God could help him. He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled, went to town. At the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. Students, he wrote to God, he addressed the letter to God on the envelope, then put the letter inside. After writing the letter, he put the letter inside the envelope, addressing to God. This was the only address to God. You can think how innocent he was when he writes this address to God. He thinks his letter will reach God and he will help me. So here you can know what kind of person he is. Very innocent, far away from worldly evilness or any other thing. So at the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. After reaching the post office, he put a stamp on the letter, then dropped the letter into the mailbox. One of the employees, who was a postman and also helped at the post office, went to his boss laughing heartily and showed him the letter to God. Never in his career as a postman had he known that address. One of the employees, means post office of that, a postman of that post office, saw Lencho putting this letter into the mailbox. When he saw the address, he broke into laughter to show the letter in the name of God. So he took it to the postmaster. In his career, he never ever saw such a letter with such address. So he broke into laughter. Thereafter, he took it to the postmaster of that post office. The postmaster, a fat, amiable fellow, also broke out laughing, but almost immediately he turned serious and, tapping the letter on his desk, commented, "What fate! I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this. later starting up a correspondence with God. Postmaster had also the same reaction. He also broke into laughter when he saw the address. So but after some time he became serious to see Lenchow's faith, deep faith in God, and he was so impressed with the faith of Lenchow. He said, "What faith? I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter, starting up a correspondence with God." He was impressed as Lenchow started the letter he addressed to God, and this word impressed the postman so much, so he wished that if he had the same faith in God like Lenchow. So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea, answer the letter. But when he opened it was evident that to answer it he needed something more than goodwill ink and paper. So at first when the postmaster saw the address that then he decided to open the letter and reply it. But when he read the whole letter and found that Lenchow needed 100 pesos, so he understood only reply is not enough. He needed something more to help him, and it was 100 pesos. But he was determined to help him. So he asked for money from his employers. He himself gave part of his salary, and several friends of his obliged to give something for an act of charity. So he told his employees, they all gave something as a donation for Lenchow. Postmaster himself gave a part of his salary, and his several friends also donated some money for an act of charity. It was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos, so he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. He put this money in an envelope addressed to Lenchow, and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature, God. So but it was very difficult for the postmaster to collect 100 pesos. He could only collect a little more than half. It was 70 pesos. Then thereafter he put the 70 pesos in the envelope and signed as a God. Only he signed God and put the money inside the envelope. The postmaster wanted to show through the letter that God has sent the money. When he signed God, he wrote nothing. He wrote only God, and he thought Lenchow will think that God has sent him the money. So to keep his faith firm in God, he did this. Students, thereafter second part of the story has ended, and here three questions are there, and you have to write the answers of these three questions in your copy. So just complete your work as I told you in my previous video.